Hello, my name is Pasi Lensu and I'm going to tell you about the lake of Valkeajärvi, which is located near the city of Kitee in eastern Finland. Valkeajärvi is one of the best lakes for scuba diving in Finland because water is very clear, which makes the visibility excellent. There is lots of activity underwater, like pike, perch, crayfish, burbot, water lilies, etc. It's end of the July and water temperature is warmest of the year. From surf to 10 meter, 30 feet depth, water temperature is 22 Celsius, 72 Fahrenheit. When we are diving deeper than that, the temperature drops very rapidly. Sometimes we can see the halocline effect on the level where the warm and cold water is mixed together. In the depth of 20 meter, 60 feet and lower, the water temperature is 4 Celsius, 39 Fahrenheit through the whole year. That's why we use wetsuits when we are diving in shallow water and dry suits when we are diving to deeper to cold water. At the winter time, pike go to deeper water where those are almost impossible to find. But when the water is warmest, from the middle of July to end of August, they are coming to shallow water. Pike are very territorial fishes because they could stay on the same places at least for 7 weeks. They are predators and kings of the lakes because they eat smaller fishes. They don't have any enemy underwater except bigger and old pike, which can eat smaller ones. Fishermen can be their only enemy above the water. Crayfish are also mainly resting at the daytime and looking for food at the nighttime. Crayfish eat living and dead animals and plants. They are digging the holes under rocks, which are easy to find where is lots of white sand next to rocks. Otherwise the color of the bottom would be brownish. Sun rays are reflecting to the water where Seppo and Sami are chilling out and looking at the beauty of underwater world. Old trees fall down to the bottom of the lake and make beautiful wrecks. Here I am shooting myself with my underwater video camera. Here is an old rowing boat wreck where the school of perch is looking the shelter for pike. Here you can see three pike at the same time observing me. One of them decide to have a closer look of me. Pike let divers to come very close. After 1 meter, 3 feet, they go away very slowly. Pike are behaving that way only in lakes where is good visibility. Lakes where the water is dark, it is very difficult even to find pike. And if I'm lucky to see it, it will escape right away. dark water makes pike and all other fishes more shy. Pike are most active at nighttime when they are eating. Daytime they are just resting and chilling out. Pike is having a very good camouflage. Color and shape of the body makes it very difficult to see, especially front of it. Here is one pike between me and my buddy Mikko, who doesn't see that pike at the beginning. Just when the pike decides to move, it is easier to see. Now the pike is distracted and it doesn't let divers to come closer him anymore. Here you can see very big burbot, which lives always in cold water. That's how it has to stay lower than 15 meter, 45 feet depth. It lives in holes on the bottom of the lake. Burbot eat nighttime little fishes and sometimes even crayfishes. This old burbot lives always in the same hole. We gave her name of Big Mama. She was distracted of my very strong video light and that's why she wanted to come out of her hole. After she noticed that she doesn't have to be afraid of me, she tried to fit her back to her hole. Here I am using my dry suit and dry hood to prevent the cold water. Now Big Mama seems to be interested of me. She is having on her lower jaw a little string which she is touching and testing her environment. When burbot get older, her eyes get almost blind because of the cataract. Then her eyes seems like there would be a white layer on the top of her eyes. It is time to leave her alone to the darkness and dive back to shallow water where is more sunlight. Here you can see three pike between me and my diving buddy Mikko. Here is my Canon PowerShot G9 digital camera with iClide housing and Inon macro lens and D2000 strobe. It's end of our dive and it's time to go back home to fill up tanks for the next dive.